Now, arithmetic sequence, let us define arithmetic sequence. Now, let us define arithmetic sequence. A sequence whose terms are obtained by adding a fixed number to the previous term. That is, if A1 is the first one and D is a fixed number, then the arithmetic sequence can be calculated as, that is, A1 is the first one and add the fixed number D to the previous one, we get the next one, A1 plus D. When we add D with the first one, A1, we obtain the next one, A1 plus D, and when we add the same fixed number D to this one, we get the next one, A1 plus 2D, and add D with this one, we get A1 plus 3D, the next one, and add D with this one, we get the next one, A1 plus 4D, and so on. So, according to the definition, the given sequence is an arithmetic sequence. There is no condition on the first one, but on the fixed number, the condition is D is never equal to 0. That is, there is a function when we substitute the natural number, the first natural number 1 on the in the function f of 1, the value of the f of 1 is equal to a1, the value of f of 2 is equal to a1 plus d, the value of the function r at the point 3 is equal to f of 3 is equal to a1 plus 2d, the value of the function at the point 4 on the natural number 4 is a1 plus 3d, and the value of the function f at a point 5 is a1 plus 2d, and so on. Now to calculate the general formula, the general function. In this case, we can calculate the general formula for an arithmetic sequence or arithmetic progression. That is, in the arithmetic sequence, there is a function f of n or an. Such that f of 1 is equal to a1, f of 2 is equal to a1 plus d, the second term is denoted by a2, f of 3 is equal to a1 plus 2d, it is denoted by a3, it can also be denoted by a3, f of 4 is equal to a1 plus 3d, we can represent this term by a4 also, f of 5 is equal to a1 plus 4d, it can also be represented by a5 and so on. Now, let us generalize these terms we have. In each term, there is a number a1 and b. But in the first term, there is only one term a1. So, a1 can also be written in the form of a1 plus 0 multiplied by d. 0 multiplied by d is equal to 0. 0 plus a1 is equal to a1. Therefore, it can easily be converted into the generalized form. That is, a1 is the coefficient and power of a1 in each term is the same, but the power of d in each term is the same, which is equal to 1, but the coefficient in each term is different. So, compare the coefficient with the number. With the natural number. Therefore, here the number is 1, the coefficient is 0, here the number is 2, the coefficient is 1 equal to 1, here the number is 3, the coefficient is 2, here the number is 4, coefficient is 3. So, therefore, the coefficient of D is less than 1 from the number. Therefore, in the generalized form, the a1, the power and coefficient of a1 in each term is equal to 1. Therefore, in the generalized form, the a1 with the power and coefficient of a1 will be equal to 1 plus d, the power of d in each term is equal to 1, d raised to the power 1, but the coefficient of
the coefficient of b in each term is less than the number, therefore f of n is equal to n minus 1. In this case, the coefficient of b is also is less than 1 by, is less than the number by 1. For example, the question is calculate the arithmetic progression arithmetic sequence whose first term is 2 and fixed number is also called common difference b is equal to 3, which is not equal to 0. There is a condition on the common difference. The condition is that the common difference will be never equal to 0. That is the general term of the arithmetic sequence is a1 is the first term, and the next term is add the common difference with the previous term, we get the next term a1 plus b, and again add the common difference to the previous term, we get the next term a1 plus b plus b is equal to a1 plus 2d, and when we add the common difference to the previous term, we get the next term a1 plus 2d plus b is equal to a1 plus 3d, and a1 plus 3d plus b is equal to a1 plus 2d, and so on. Substitute the values a1 and b from the given data, we have a1 is equal to 2, a1 plus b which is equal to 5, a1 plus 2 multiplied by d is equal to 3, 6 plus 2 is equal to 8, a1 plus 3 multiplied by d is equal to 3, 9 plus 2 is equal to 11, and a1 is equal to 2 plus 4 multiplied by d, 12 plus 2 is equal to 14, and so on. This is a required sequence defined by a1 and d. Second method for the calculation of the above sequence, when we have the general term of the sequence is an is equal to a1 plus n minus 1 multiplied by d, where a1 is the first term and d is a common difference. In this case, a1 is equal to 2 and the common difference is equal to 3, substitute the values a1 and d. We have 2 plus n minus 1 multiplied by 3. After the simplification, we get an is equal to 3n minus 1, where n is a natural number. This is the general formula for the calculation of the above sequence. This is the second method for the calculation. In this case, first we have to calculate the function for the calculation of the required sequence. Now, according to the conditions, the domain set for this function is the set of natural number. So a1 is equal to 3 multiplied by 1 minus is equal to 2. a2 is equal to 3 multiplied by 2 minus is equal to 5. a3 is equal to 3 multiplied by 3 minus is equal to 8. a4 is equal to 3 multiplied by 4 minus is equal to 11, and so on. Therefore, the required sequence is 2, 5, 8, 11, and so on, which is the above sequence.